Okay, we're going to talk today about how to pull an APA citation for an article or a book from a library database. So I've run a search here in our database system. This is EBSCO Discovery System and or EBSCO Discovery Service, and it comes from here from the library website. I clicked on Advanced Search right there. You could also run a search in this box. And then I ran a search on Project Management. Then I set it to peer reviewed, so I'm just looking at peer reviewed articles. We'll go back later and find something more general. So let's see here. Let me just open this article up here. And to get a citation, what I can do for this, there's a citation assistant right here where it says cite. Now I want to warn you, you're going to have to make corrections to the citation. Citation assistants are great to use and they'll save you some time, but you have to make corrections to them. You can't just assume that they're correct, because there always will be errors in these, always, okay? So I'm gonna click cite here. You see a list of different citation types. I'm gonna look on that list until I find APA. There's APA 7th edition. So I'm gonna copy this citation here and I'm going to paste it into a Word document where I will have to make corrections. I guarantee you, there's always corrections that need to be made on these. So I'm gonna paste it there. Do you see that gray background and all that stuff that came in and how it's not indented correctly? If you turn it in like this and tell your teacher, but I pulled it from a citation assistant, it has to be correct, it's going to be wrong. The citation assistant is there to save you some time. There's no guarantee that it's completely correct, okay? So I don't have to type all this in myself, but I do have to make some changes. The first thing I'm going to do is click this clipboard here and click the blue arrow in the middle. That selection in the middle will remove any of the strange formatting. Okay, so now it's starting to look more normal. Now, there's going to have to be corrections made to this. What I would recommend doing, start off at the library website, go right here to where it says library handouts, and pull up this APA reference citation guide. Okay, so once again, here, I was on the library website, I went to library handouts, then I went right here to APA reference citation guide. And this is going to pull up a bunch of examples for what correct citations should look like. So I'm looking at article from an online database here with the DOI. We'll talk about the DOI in a little bit. So I go back to my Word document. Okay, there's this. Now let me look at what I have here. So notice it's indented over. That's the first thing that looks different. This is called a hanging indent. This is over to the left. All future lines are indented over a half an inch. Okay, let's look at some other things. Here's how they list the authors, the year. Okay, now, in APA, they write their titles as if they're sentences, which is a little strange. Notice, only the first word is capitalized. You're probably used to seeing titles where everything, all of the words are capitalized. In APA, unless there's a proper noun, you only capitalize the first word of your title. If you get to a subtitle, like here's an article with a subtitle, after the subtitle, you start to capitalize again. But then immediately you go back to not capitalizing. Okay, so let's just look this over really quickly. So that should be written like a sentence. The title of the journal should be all of the words capitalized. Okay, so that's how a normal title will look. The title of the journal will be italicized. The journal, the volume will be italicized. The issue will not be italicized in parentheses, comma, page number, period. And if there's a DOI, you list a DOI. Okay, so let's go back to our Word document here and see how that lines up. So this looks good. The authors look good. Make sure if there's two initials, you put a space in there, comma between the authors. Always list last name first. You never put the first name, just the initials. If an author lists two initials, you put two initials in there. Okay, and then before you get to the last author, there's an ampersand, not the word and, ampersand. Okay, then we've got the year. That's good, period. Now, you can see there's some problems here because this came in like a normal title. All of the words are capitalized. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to highlight all of the letters that don't need to be capitalized, and I'm going to uncapitalize them, and I'll show you a little trick for that. So I'm holding down the control key, and I'm going to highlight the things that don't need to be capitalized. Now this would need to be capitalized because it's after the colon. The subtitle, you start the capitalization over again. So that would not need to be capitalized. None of these other words would need to be capitalized, okay? So I've got them all highlighted. Now on my keyboard, I'm going to hold down Shift F3, and it changes the capitalization back and forth so that you don't have to retype all those letters. Okay, so that's my little trick there. I highlighted all the things that did not need to be capitalized. Hold down my control key so I can highlight them one at a time. Held down Shift and F3. Okay, here's the journal title. That's correct. It's capitalized and it's italicized. There's the volume number, italicized. There's the issue number, comma, page numbers, and a DOI. Okay, so it looks pretty good. Now, the last thing we have to do, we have to get this is called a hanging indent. We have to get that indentation in there. Now, I don't want to just hit here and start hitting the tab key, because sometimes the tab key doesn't work correctly, or it will tab your whole thing over, or if you need to go in and correct or change anything in here, the tab will not necessarily stick. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to highlight this. I'm going to go up here to paragraph, and there's a little arrow next to here. I'm going to click that, and under indentation for special, I'm going to click hanging indent. Okay, that's going to add a half an inch hanging indent, and you can see a preview of what it's going to look like here, and that's correct. Okay, so there's a citation. Let's go get another one. Let's go back to our database search here. I'm going to click result list here. And we'll pull down this list here. Doesn't really matter which ones we choose. Again, I'm going to click the cite button right here. I'm going to look for an APA citation. Okay, there's the APA citation right there. I'm going to copy this and I'm going to paste it in. Now this one might be more correct. I can see the title is a little bit more correct, not completely correct. So they'll all be a little bit different. They will all have different errors, but the main thing is remember you will have to correct the errors. Don't just turn it in. Okay, now this one, Word kind of sensed, oh, you're looking for a hanging indent, right? So it put the hanging indent on. It might take it off when I like to start from scratch. I'm going to click that blue arrow to remove any of the formatting. Okay, it kept the hanging indent on and the double spaced. That's cool. Okay, let's look here. So we've got the authors. Last name, first initial, last name, first initial. Ampersand, last name, first initial, the year. Okay, now manifesto does not need to be capitalized. Otherwise, everything else is correct there. So I'm just going to hit Shift F3. Okay, the title of the journal is capitalized, italicized, volume. Okay. And it has a DOI. Now a DOI is a digital object identifier. Okay, it's kind of like an ISBN or a serial number for the article. This is not really the URL or the article. It's a locator. This is like the standard identifier for this article. Okay, and in APA, APA considers this the most standard identifier of this article. If you have an article that you get from a library database that does not have a DOI, you don't need to list a URL, okay? The new rules, or not so new anymore, a few years old, the 7th edition rules for APA say, if it comes from a library database, if there's not a DOI, don't worry about listing a URL, okay? Because these are readily available. Most people can find these by the title. And the URL will, if it's from a library database, will be specific to your institution only. That URL would only mean anything to your institution. So here we go. We got another one in there. Okay. Let's go and get something that's not a journal article. We'll get a few other things, actually. Let's go back here to our search. We'll say, when this goes back to the results, I have the peer-reviewed limiter on, so we're only looking at peer-reviewed articles. Let me take that off here. Okay, and I'm going to grab something that's from a magazine, just a regular popular magazine article. And so these are a lot more general. Now, if I open up one of these, I'm looking through here. If it has a DOI, it'll list a DOI. Okay, so this is an example of one. Peer-reviewed articles almost always have DOIs. Popular magazine articles, generally speaking, do not have DOIs. Okay, so the citation will look a little bit different with this one. There won't be a URL or a DOI at the end, and that's correct. So we have a couple of interesting issues here. Let's go to cite. We'll get our APA citation here. We're going to paste this in. Now, it's doing pretty good, but it keeps bringing in that gray highlighting. And that's hard to get rid of if you try to take it off using your limits here. So go up here, right here to this clipboard, blue arrow. There you go. Okay, let's look at the authors. They look good. They look good using the ampersand. Okay, 2024. Now, just like the other titles we've seen, we have to decapitalize these. Uncapitalize, lowercase them, whatever you want to say. So I should be capitalized. That's because I is always capitalized when it's alone like that. Should because it's the first word. But the rest of these should not be capitalized. So new project management system. Okay, and I just did Shift F3 and uncapitalized those. Here's, now this is an interesting question. What about if the title ends in a question mark? Do I add a period here? No. If it ends in a question mark, if the title ends in a question mark, which is very common, you just let that be the end. Or as generally speaking, when you get to the end of a title, there's a period. If there's already punctuation in the title and it ends in a question mark, do not add a period right there. Okay, if you look on the guide here that we had from the library, let's look through here. That's listed in one of these rules. Let's see. So that's the nice thing about going to this little guide here. You can look up all of these different types of situations. What you really should do is get the APA manual, but this is kind of like the greatest hits of the MLA. Okay, title ends in a question mark. Don't use another period at the end of the title. Okay, there's that rule right there. You just let the question mark be the end. Okay, now notice here. There's the volume, there's the issue. There's no DOI at the end, and there's no URL. That is correct. It might look strange to you. Your instructor might even argue with you, but the current rules of APA say if it comes from a library database, don't list a URL. And there's a few reasons for that. One, this URL up here, this doesn't mean anything. This will expire, okay? Also, this URL, you could generate a URL right here. This URL, notice it has the school name in the URL. This URL is created specifically for our subscription to this database. This URL wouldn't mean anything to anyone else outside of our system. So the URL isn't really that useful from a library database, except within your school. And the idea of APA is it's a very standard system. So APA wants to see that DOI at the end. If there's not a DOI, do not list a URL. All right. And if you look up here in our little handout, there's a DOI there. Here's one that shows if it comes from the library database and there's no DOI, don't put a URL or database reference at the end. This is the way you would. You would cite it as if you had the physical magazine with you. So exactly the same. Okay, so that's correct. It may look strange to you, but that's correct. Let's do something else here. Let's go back to our database search. Let's go back to the results list. And let's change this. We had a limiter on here just to look at magazine articles. Let's take that off. Let's just look at everything again. Now here's a book, or here are books that are coming up here. Let's go into this book. Okay, so here's a book. Now, before I do anything, I'm going to go to my little list here. I'm going to pull down the screen. So we're looking at articles. Now I'm going to look at book. Okay, this is how a book should be cited. And there's different forms. If you're citing an individual chapter or whatever, but the chapters for books and the different rules for books are pretty similar. So here we go. Ebook access from a library database. Since this ebook was found in the library database and there's no DOI, don't include a URL or permalink in the citation. So really, the ebook, if you found it in a library database, should be cited as if you just have a regular book, a regular print book in front of you. Okay, so that's what this is. This is a book. And notice in the rules here, the title of an ebook or any kind of book, the title of a book follows the same rules of capitalization, but the title is italicized. That's different from an article. Okay? An article, the title of the article is not italicized. It's just straight. But with a book, let's look at the book again, and I'm going to pull this down, and I would use this if I was going, I personally have this printed out, and I have an APA manual, and when I have a question, I go to these printouts or to my APA manual. I definitely recommend buying the APA manual, by the way. It's about $20, very good money. You will use it all the time. Okay, but so we're going to take a look at this. So we're going to list the author, the year, the title of the book, and then the publisher, and that's it. We don't list a city of publication, a state, country of publication, none of that. Okay, so let's go here. Let's pull up Citation. There's the cite button right there. Whoops, went past it. There's the APA citation right there. Now, I see some errors here. They're listing the first name of the author. See, and there's all capitalization. So there's all sorts of problems with this. Again, these will save you some time, but they make errors. Don't just copy and paste these and turn it in and tell your teacher, but it came from the database. It has to be correct. That's not how it works. It'll save you time, but you have to make corrections. Any citation generator you use from any system, whether it's a library database or a website, there are some good websites out there. They almost always make errors. Okay, I'm going to paste this in. We're going to, you know the drill. I'm going to do my blue arrow here. Okay, now that's wrong. Marco is the author's first name. So we would do this, last name, M. Get rid of that. Okay, here's the year. Now it is right that it's italicized. That's good. That does not need to be capitalized. That does not need to be capitalized. That does not need to be capitalized. And we don't need this extra space. A lot of times they'll add a little extra space after the colon. You can take that out. Now, that would be capitalized because it's the first word of the title. That would not be. This would, because after the colon for the subtitle, you would start capitalizing again. There and there. Okay, here is the publisher. And that's all correct. And that is, you read it, this is capitalized, it's a proper noun, and there's a period at the end. No URL at the end, there's no DOI. That's what it looks like. It looks a little strange, but that is the correct way. Let's grab another one. Let's go back here to the results list. I'm going to hit the cite button here. APA citation. You see more errors in there. I sure do. Copy it. Okay. We're going to hit the blue arrow in the middle to remove the weird formatting. Okay, look at this. See, that's wrong. So James W. Marion, what we do is Marion J. W. And you put a space there between the initials because he lists a middle initial. We don't want his first name in there. That's how it's done. Here's the year, the period. Okay, that should not be capitalized. We're going to remove that space. These are common things that they make these mistakes over and over again. That does not need to be capitalized. Hold down the control key. Does not need to be capitalized. Does not need to be capitalized. Does not need to be capitalized. That does, because Pimbach. That doesn't. Part two does not. Shift F3. There's the title, there's the publisher. Both of those words do need to be capitalized, period. That's it. Okay, so that is how you use the databases to pull citations and correct those citations. The important word there is correct. You will have to edit these and correct them because they always make mistakes, always. They save you a lot of time. That's really easy. And once you get doing this, it's so quick. But now, the last thing I would do with this, I would alphabetize this list, okay? Because these these are not following alphabetical order here, and they should. So what I would do, I would not cut and paste and move things around because you can lose formatting that way. I would highlight everything in the list. I would go up here to A to Z, and then I would sort them A to Z. Now, it kept the same formatting, but it put them into alphabetical order. Okay, that's a quick intro for how to use databases to pull citations with the Citation Assistant and, most importantly, how to correct them. Thank you very much for watching.